When it comes to trying to sorting out our billionaire class now, like the way that I, my own judgment is your top priority climate change and population management, or is it exploring space? Because if you're up for exploring space, then you obviously don't hate humanity and you want to expand. But if your concern is climate change and population control, you probably do hate humanity. And therefore, I don't want you to be involved in big biomedical breakthroughs. I don't want you buying up farmland. So Bill Gates, bad billionaire. Elon Musk, good billionaire. I don't really know what to do with Jeff Bezos in this because he looks like a bad billionaire, but he wants to explore space. So he's kind of he's the radical centrist in my model. But it is interesting seeing now some of these, because this is one of the perks of Twitter and some of these platforms, is now you get to see a little bit of bickering out in public that would otherwise kind of be constrained to smoke-filled rooms. And so earlier this week, Jeff Bezos tweeted out, he was tweeting a thread that was talking about Tesla's reliance on the Chinese market. And kind of the threads, the gist of that thread was, you know, is Elon compromised by China and will that affect Twitter? And so Jeff Bezos tweets out this thread and just says, interesting question. Did the Chinese government just gain a bit of leverage over the town square? Obviously referring to Musk's purchase. And then right under it, he has a follow-up tweet. My answer to this is probably not, but, and somebody just threw out that first tweet just because he knew that the first tweet gets 11,000 retweets. The second one saying, probably not, gets less than 700. But so you just know they're kind of poking each other, which again, it's interesting right now. We're seeing, and part of this is a reflection of the fact that, you know, the legislative process itself, right, doesn't work quite well. It's really good at just creating a bunch of, you know, spending a bunch of money that it then often ends up the pockets of these oligarchs. And so if you really, I think your average person recognizes perhaps more than ever before that, you know, the owner of Amazon and Bill Gates and Elon Musk and these folks are a lot more important than, you know, their congressmen. And so there's a lot more intrigue. And also, again, I think this is also a good thing, a lot more suspicion of the larger agendas of these folks. And so again, this is simply another card to a very interesting deck of storylines of the oligarch class in America.